Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shooking. Today we are making crispy corn chili in restaurant style. The taste is fantastic guys and the corn will be super crunchy. Hear the sound? The sound is amazing, isn't it? So let's get cooking. First we will boil the sweet corn, otherwise they can pop in the oil guys. So here I have taken a saucepan. In this I am adding 1.5 cups of frozen sweet corn. Along with this we will add water enough to cover the sweet corn, and we will cover the pot also in high flame. We have to boil this. Once the water comes to a boil, we will lower the flame to medium and boil it for 5 minutes. Here the corn is ready. Now let me turn off the flame. We will take it out and strain it. The corn is loaded with moisture, so we have to dry it. You can place it on a towel or a cloth, cover and rub like this to dry it. If you have time, you can also keep it under a fan for 15 to 20 minutes. So the corn is ready. Now for the coating that makes it crunchy and crispy, we will take it out into a large bowl. Try to use a large mixing bowl because we will do a lot of mixing, mashing and tossing. Here the corn is ready. To season, I am taking salt as per taste. Along with that, chili powder 1/2 teaspoon. Here I am taking yellow chili powder. Any pepper powder or chili powder can be used. For making the coating, we will first add maida or plain flour 1 tablespoon and corn starch or corn flour 2 tablespoons. You can also use arrowroot flour. Now get your hands in and mash the corn. Like we do potato, right? You have to mash the corn, but not completely. Just ensure the corn pieces burst. If you don't do this step correctly, then when we fry the corn, the moisture inside the corn will expand and the corn will burst in the oil. So it's better to tear the corn right now by mashing it like this, and the excess moisture will come out and the flour will stick to it. That's the science behind it. So after a few seconds itself, you will notice how this gets sticky and all the flour is stuck to the corn pieces. Now we will add more corn flour or corn starch 2 tablespoons and maida 1 tablespoon. Always keep the ratio 2:1. We will mix and mash again until it doesn't look powdery and dry. We do this step 3 to 4 times or until it doesn't absorb any more flour. 2 times have been done. Now I am adding more corn flour and maida into this. This is the 3rd time. I have mixed it again for the 3rd time and now you can see the coating is done, but we have excess maida and corn flour. We will stick it again to the corn itself. For that, take a little bit of water, about 1 teaspoon, sprinkle it and then toss the bowl, something like this. If you don't feel confident, you can also move it with a spoon very quickly. Don't add more than 1 teaspoon of water at a time, otherwise the water and flour or corn flour will clump together, which we don't want. You might have to add water 2 to 3 times depending upon how floury or how powdery the coating was. Here you can see the coating is very well done. When I check it with my hand, there is minimal dry flour after the corn is fallen down. The corn is ready. We will let it rest for about 2 minutes. While the corn is resting, let's heat up some oil for frying. Once the oil is hot, we have to do one more step before frying the corn, which is to take a colander or a vegetable strainer. In this, we will add the corn and shake it over a plate to remove all the excess dry flour. We will fry the corn in 2 batches, so this is just half the corn, and after shaking we are ready to fry. The excess dry flour is out. The oil is hot in high flame. I am lowering it to medium. We will add the corn. Immediately cover it with a lid 90%. Don't cover it fully, otherwise there will be a lot of water going back into the oil and it will splutter a lot. Keep the flame medium right now. We will fry it for about 2 minutes in medium flame or until it starts to float. Initially guys, when you add the corn into the hot oil, you might hear a few spluttering sounds. If you have done the coating right, don't worry about it. What happens is the steam comes up, it goes back again as moisture, and that in oil, you know what happens, it makes sounds, right? But since we have covered it with the lid, don't worry about it. It's been 2 minutes and most of the corn is floating right now. You can open the lid now, there is no more danger. Stir it a little so that it fries evenly. We will fry the corn until it goes light brown in color. Once you see this color, our corn is ready. We will take it out and place it in a plate. But don't line the plate with a paper or a kitchen towel or a tin foil, otherwise it will get soggy in a minute. I am basically using a pizza screen on top of a plate right now. This way, the steam will escape and the corn will not get soggy. The first batch is done. Now I am adding the second batch for frying right now, immediately covering the pan with a lid. The second batch is also done. Hear the sound? Crispy corn is ready, but this is half the battle. We have to bring the chili pepper element also. When we cook recipes like this one, lots of greasy fumes and smoke rise from the pan, and these days even chimneys come with oil collectors. Think about it. Being around, taking care of our skin is extremely important. We all do a face wash. But that's not enough. I follow a two-step regime to rejuvenate and cleanse my skin every week. Let me take you through. So I have washed my face with a face wash. Now it's time for Mama Earth Upton face scrub. Unlike ordinary scrub, this is made in traditional Upton style with goodness of turmeric and saffron. Just like how these enhanced food, I am talking about turmeric and saffron. Turmeric fights dull, dry and damaged skin, and saffron with its antioxidants and vitamins soothes it. So the scrub opens the pores of our skin and deeply cleans it by scrubbing off any excess dirt, grease, dead skin and all. Just like how we clean a oily tawa. Jokes aside, this is on a milder scale. Scrub is done, pores are open, need to close them now. Here I have Upton face mask from Mama Earth. Before I have to stay mum, Mama Earth is our Indian brand and I am super happy to be vocal for local, and Mama Earth is now officially certified as cruelty free from PETA. The mask along with turmeric and saffron had apricot oil to moisturize the skin and cucumber extract to soothe it. I feel really fresh, skin feels smooth and bright. The best part I am happy about is all Mama Earth products are free from harsh chemicals and made with natural ingredients. You can also get these for a cool 20% off using the coupon code COOKING2020, available at Mama Earth, Amazon and Flipkart. Now let's make the corn chili. I have a large kadhai or a Chinese wok. Any steel pan will also be good. This is very thin, so it will heat up really well in high flame. We will get the same restaurant flavor using this. In high flame, I am adding 2 tablespoons of oil from the sides. This way, nothing will stick to the kadhai. Once the oil gets hot, we will add garlic. 3 tablespoons of garlic I am adding right now. This is roughly chopped. Along with this, 3 green chili which are chopped, and we will stir fry this for about 15 to 20 seconds in high flame. We want the raw flavor of garlic, so don't cook it very much. Looks good. Capsicum goes in next. This is 1 medium sized capsicum which I have chopped fine. We will add it in and fry really well. You have to add red chili before adding the capsicum. I forgot about it, so here I am using 4 dry red chilies which are chopped using a scissor without the seeds. When you cut it using a scissor, most of the seeds come out and then you can add it without the seeds. Now we will stir fry this together for about a minute in high flame. The capsicum and chili is done, these are fried. Now we are going to add pepper powder, half a teaspoon. Along with that, salt to season. Instead of white pepper, you can also use Kashmiri red chili powder or Biadgi red chili powder. That way you won't have to add the red food color that I'm adding right now. Restaurants also add MSG or flavoring salt, I'm skipping that today. You can add it for the same authentic taste. Next, I'm adding tomato ketchup 1 tablespoon to balance the spiciness and chili sauce 1/2 tablespoon. We are done, give it a stir, we will fry it for a few seconds to mix everything. The color looks good, the capsicum is also fried. For coating this into the corn, we have to make a slurry of corn starch. This is 1 teaspoon of corn starch, we will mix it with about 3 tablespoons of water. Now we will add it to the pan little at a time and mix it. Keep the flame medium, we have to cook this for about 30 seconds to get rid of the raw flavor of corn flour. Now if this gets too thick, then you can add 2 tablespoons of water. Final mix, our chili mix is ready, now we are going to add the corn into it. Turn off the flame when you are adding the corn. If the flame is on, then the corn will get soggy, otherwise it doesn't get soggy even after 1 hour. I'm giving it a nice mix and our crunchy crispy chili corn is ready to enjoy. Before serving, you can garnish it with some greens. So how was the crispy corn chili recipe guys? If you enjoyed it, give it a like, share it with your friends. If you did not like it, click the dislike button. I am sharing the link to Mama Earth products down below. You can check it out there. See you soon with one more video. Bye guys, take care.